Hi, everybody. My name is Dale Grauman. I am a professional coach at the Writing, Reading, and Speech Assistance area at the College of DuPage. In this video, I'm going to show you how to record a slideshow in PowerPoint. Okay, we're starting with a very basic slideshow. It has three slides. Each of those slides just has a number written on them. I'm going to show you how to record the show with automated slide timings and with narrations. You're going to go to Slideshow. Then you're going to go to Setup Slideshow and make sure that you have these settings checked. Presented by a speaker and full screen. You want to use timings if present. You want to make sure all is clicked right here. And the slideshow monitor, it should just be on automatic. Then click OK. Then you're going to go here to Record Slideshow and record from the beginning. That pulls up this screen where you can begin recording. You're going to want to make sure that your microphone is turned on. If it's checked with, or if there's a line through it like this, it's turned off. So make sure that's turned on. It should look like that. Now to record narrations and timings into the slide, you'd go up here to hit to this red button and hit record. So I'm going to record something pretty simple. There's a countdown. One. This is the number one. All right, after I was done recording, I hit stop. And now I can play back what I've recorded so far and see if I like it. One. This is the number one. All right, so one thing I want you to notice is after it's done replaying, it automatically takes you to the next slide. So it went from one to two after it was done replaying back what I had said. Now, I don't like what I said, so I want to re-record. So I have to go back to slide one, and then I can hit record again, and it will record over what I recorded on slide one the first time. One. All right, I just want that, so let's see how it sounds. One. Okay, that sounds fine to me. Let's record something into slide two. And this time, I'm going to show you how to use the pen as well. So before I record, I'm going to go down and select, let's see, I want blue ink, and I want to be using the pen tool. Oh wait, blue ink, pen tool. Okay, so while I'm recording, I'm going to use the pen to underline something in the slide. Two. Okay, I'm going to replay this. Two. That looks good to me. It automatically advanced to the third slide. I'm just going to record something for the third slide like normal. Three. Let's listen to that. Three. And it automatically advanced to the end of the slideshow. And if I want to finish, I can just click anywhere in the screen and it will exit out. I can also exit out up here. Okay. So I went back to the first slide and I'm going to hit this button to view the slideshow. It should replay the narrations. It should advance through them automatically. One. Two. Three. Okay, that looks pretty good to me. I'm going to show you one thing that you may want to verify about the slideshow. There's a little icon in the corner of each slide. See that little icon down in the right corner? That icon it indicates that there are narrations in the slideshow. If I click this play button, one, I can hear the narration. Click on the icon, go to playback under audio tools, and just make sure this box is checked for each one that says hide during show. I'm gonna go to the next one. Hide during show, okay. If you don't do that, the little icon's going to be visible. And if you have an automated slideshow like this, you probably don't want that icon to be visible. Hide during show. Okay, so that might be the automatic setting in PowerPoint. I'm not sure, but you will probably just wanna verify that those are hidden during your slideshow. Okay. Now what you want to do is, let's see. Now what you want to do is save it. I'm gonna go to File, Save As. Instead of saving as a PowerPoint as a PowerPoint presentation, I'm going to hit this downward facing arrow and save it as a PowerPoint show, a .ppsx file. Let's see, where is this being saved to? It's being saved to my desktop. That's fine. I'll be able to find it there. I'm hitting save. Let's check out my desktop. All right, this ppsx file is the file I just saved. I'm going to just open that. One, two, three. Okay, and that's the end of the show. It automatically did all that when I opened the slideshow file. Now you can save this slideshow file and you can email it to somebody, you can upload it to Blackboard, whatever you need to do to get it to somebody else. And when they double click on it, if they have PowerPoint on their computer, it's going to automatically open up, automatically play through the slideshow with your recordings, with your timing, with your narration, with everything. There's one more option. Let's see, you go back to our slideshow here. And you can also save it as a video. Go to save as, go to MPEG4 video, a .mp4 file. I'm going to hit save again to my desktop. And it may take a minute to create this file. I don't think this one is quite ready yet. There it goes. All right, it may take a minute to create your video file. If you double click on the video file, it will play on any computer.
One, two, three.
It'll play on any computer that has a video playing application in it, which is like most computers. You can also upload this to YouTube or Vimeo or wherever you would like to upload your video. So the downside to saving it as a video is that you're generally going to get much larger file sizes if you save it as a video, and that could be an issue for you uploading and downloading and storing the file. So if you think file size could be an issue, it's a better idea to save it as a PPSX file. If you don't know whether the person you're sharing it with has access to PowerPoint, the video file should be playable on anything, so that's an advantage of the video file. If you are savvy enough with YouTube or Vimeo or some other video software that you could upload this to the internet and have it stream from a video playing service, that's another advantage of video. Okay, that's everything I have for you today. If you would like more help using PowerPoint, you could make an appointment with us at the Writing, Reading, and Speech Assistance area in the Learning Commons. There's more information about making an appointment up on the screen. Thanks for watching!